Hi, my name is Jerzy Brzezicki, and today I will give a demo of using external forecasts in SAS Visual Forecasting and overriding them. Why would you do that, and what are the benefits of doing this? So let me start off explaining what is an OUTFOR. OUTFOR is a common denominator for results of any forecasting process. The same structure of the data is being used in SAS Forecast Server. It is being used by ProcTS model, and also the family of high performance forecasting procedures, also known as HPF procedures. So in any of those previous processes, you can create your forecasts that will be stored as an OUTFOR data, and you can import them to the SAS Visual Forecasting applications for further processing. Now, what can you do when you import this data into SAS Visual Forecasting? First of all, you can add additional data. We call it an attribute data that will allow you to do thorough investigation and exploration of your forecasts. You will be able to create very advanced filters, and I will demo that in the application. But the main reason why people may want to do that is to create overrides. So once you have your OUTFOR with your forecast, if there is any reason for you to improve the forecast, you can do that inside Visual Forecasting. So let's just start the demo. I will open Model Studio and create a forecasting project. Let's call it External OUTFOR Demo. We need to select the type, and now we're selecting the data. So again, this data will be an OUTFOR, which I prepared and actually created in another application. And that's it, I'm creating a project. So here's what will happen. When you create a standard visual forecasting project, you bring into time series. Here we brought an OUTFOR with predictions, and the application will recognize that and create a specialized pipeline for this type of a data. The modeling node in this pipeline is called external forecast. Let me just try to run it and I will explain what it does. So this special type of modeling node, external forecasts node, does not produce forecasts. It will only validate the existing data if the data structure is correct. So OUTFOR will bring here things like bivariables that are the keys for our time series and forecasts. It will bring the actuals, predictions, confidence limits. So this process will validate that you are bringing in to this project correct data. Once this data is available here, validated, I can open this node for further investigations. Forecast Viewer is a way to navigate forecasts in any modeling node. And on the left side, what you see is a faceted panel with available so far attributes. And the attributes are my primary keys, my bi groups or my bi variables. And here I can just see specific subsets of the data using this selection. So I'm selecting a campus, I'm selecting a department, and here on the right side, I have the list of my forecasts in this current filter, and I can start navigating here, selecting one or multiple forecasts and look at them. Now, on my left side, it is just the keys or bi variables. However, if I have additional attributes that are compatible with this data, I can bring them into this project. I will add external attributes to this project. This is a hard data project. And here are my attributes. They need to be compatible with my forecast data. They need to have the same keys so they can match. So now I'm bringing it into the project. So here they are. In addition to my keys, I will have additional information now available for investigation, like complexity rate, age, population, and such. So let's just see how that works in my pipeline. My pipeline needs to run one more time because I really did change the data. It will just take a few seconds, and once the new attribute data is available, you will see in the faceted panel that I can create much more advanced filters. Okay. This node did complete. I'm opening Forecast Viewer one more time. And on the left side, you see the additional attributes that we imported to this project. So let me just focus on, let's say, some type of eye surgeries for a specific urgency. And I can narrow it further for, let's say, specific complication rate. Okay, so I have a filter right now of 105 series. And again, I can start investigating one forecast at the time. Here you see it in this kind of yellow dot color. I can select multiple series. And of course, I can create or store my filter. If there is any reason for me to improve the forecast or change them, I have this available. This data will be available in the overrides module. So here I'm storing the current filter, and we just say it's some kind of eye surgery. I just created one filter. Of course, I could create many of them for any reason. And now I'm going to overrides. So again, the forecasts are brought to the override module where we can improve them. And all the attributes that we added to the project will be available here as well. So I can start navigate here and create new type of filters. The filter and functionality is similar to the previous step. However, here we see the aggregation of all the series in my current filter. So we see the aggregation at the top level of all the forecast, not series, forecast, and in the horizon area, we can change the value of the forecast. I can do it for a current filter, or I can bring the filter that I created in previous step. And let's say for any reason, I need to modify my override. So here I'm opening my override calculator, and let's say I, because of availability of resources, I need to decrease my forecast by specific value 10% on a given date. Here is my value. I need to submit that. And as soon as submission complete, I will just show you that on one specific day we decrease the forecasts. Here it is. So this is the demo of using external forecasts for two reasons in visual forecasting. Thank you very much for your attention.